Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So today we are going to learn some different things. First of all, we will learn about definite noun and indefinite noun. Look at the board. It is lesson number 3. It means ad-darsu thalis. Lesson number 3. Okay, we have finished 2 lessons and now we are going to start lesson number 3. Look, baytun, it means a house, any house. It is an indefinite noun. Definite and indefinite means if something definite, it means there it has a certainty, surety. And indefinite, you don't have certainty, you don't have surety about that person or about that things. Okay, baytun, a house, and any house. Okay, but when you will put the alif lam, then it's a sign to make noun definite. It means the house. Baytun, a house. Al baytu, the house. And remember one thing more, that if there is tanween, then alif lam would not come. And if there is alif lam, then tanween would not come. It means they both cannot coexist. If alif lam will here, then tanween would be not here. And tanween would be here, then alif lam not be here. Okay, it's clear. So baytun, a house. Al baytu, the house. Likewise, kitabun, any book, a book. Al kitabu, the book. Allah says ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِي. It means الْكِتَاب, it means Quran. It's definite book. Now after that, there are some simple sentences. How to make a simple sentence in Arabic? Look, there is الْكِتَابُ مَفْتُوحٌ. The book is opened. The book is opened. Remember one thing. Al-kitabu, it is a subject. In Arabic terms, we will say mubtada. And mubtada would be always in the subjective case. It means there must be zamma. Zamma or zammatain, like, okay. Al-kitabu maftuhun. The book is open. This is al-kitabu, its subject, and maftuhun, its predicate. And also remember one thing, subject would be marifa. It means there must be alif lam. There must be noun which will be definite. And predicate always be a indefinite. It means common noun, not proper noun. You cannot say al-kitabu al-maftu. It is a mistake. Without alif lam, al-kitabu maftuhun. The book is opened. Same way, al-qalamu maksurun. Al-qalam, it's mubtada, maksur, it's khabar. Al-qalam, subject, maksurun, predicate. But if you will say qalamun maksur, it would be wrong. It would be wrong. The meaning would be changed, totally changed. So remember this. If there is a common noun, we will make it definite. Because for which thing you wanted to give the information, something which is in your mind, and the thing which is in your mind, that means it is definite. It would not be indefinite. You can't give the information about something which is not in your mind. It would be ridiculous. The same formula apply here, okay? Subject always be marfu and definite. But something would be happened differently if there is a proper noun like Khalid, Zaid, Muhammad. Some proper noun will come here. So you will also enter the al? No, that would be wrong. You cannot say Al-Muhammadu Hafizun, Al-Muhammadu Jalisun, Al-Khalidu. That would be wrong. Because it is already proper noun, definite noun. You do not have to make it definite. Okay? So, Al-Qalamu Maksurun, the pen is broken. Al-Kitabu Maftuhun, the book is open. Al-Waladu Jalis, Jalasa Yajlisu Julusan, it means to sit down. Al-Waladu Jalisun, the boy. Al-Waladu Jalisun, the boy is sitting. Wal-Mudarris Waqifun, and the teacher is standing. Waqif, Waqafa Yaqifu Wukufan, to become, to stand up. After that, Al-Kitabu Jadidun Wal-Qalamu Qadimun, the book is new and the pen is old. Jadid, Qadim. Okay, collect the vocabulary. If you have a lot of vocabulary, you could be able to understand the language and you could be able to speak Arabic fluently. Without vocabulary, you could not be able to understand Arabic and you cannot speak Arabic. Okay? So remember these word meanings. Jadid, Qadim. Jadid, new. Qadim, old. Himaru sagirun wal hisan kabir, the donkey is small and the horse is big. Al kursiyu maksurun, the chair is broken. Al mindilu wasikhun, the handkerchief is dirty. Al ma'u baridun, the water is cold. Al qamaru jamilun, qamar. وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَهَا. قَمَر means moon. الْقَمَرُ جَمِيلٌ, the moon is beautiful. الْبَيْتُ قَرِيبٌ وَالْمَسْجِدُ بَعِيدٌ, the house is near and the masjid is far. الْحَجَرْ ثَقِيل, the stone is heavy. وَالْوَرَقْ خَفِيف, and the paper is light. الْلَبَنُ حَار, the milk is hot. الْقَمِيسُ نَظِيف, the shirt is clean. So we have finished one page. Okay, you have to practice by your own. Okay, and you have to learn the new meanings. So today we have learned definite and indefinite noun, and also we have learned to make a simple sentence like Al-Qalamu Maksurun, Al-Kursiyu Maksurun, Al-Baytu Jadidun, Al-Mudarrisu Jalisun, Al-Waladu Waqifun, likewise. Okay, like this. After this, there are exercises. Okay? So, اقرأ واكتب مع ضبط أواخر الكلمات. You have to read and write this. Okay? There is no vowel sign. You have to practice at your own. Okay? How, if there is masjid without alif lam, so how you will pronounce it? Masjidun, masjidan, masjidin. So masjidun is correct. Al masjid, it means al masjidu. Al ma, al ma'u. Ma'un, al baytu, babun, qalamun, al qalamu, al kalbu. Remember this thing. Alif lam will come, tanween would not come. Tanween is here, alif lam would not come. Okay, this is the formula. This is the main things you have to learn. After this, there are some sentences like this. Al-Maktab Maksur. Maktab means table. Al-Mudarris Jadid. Al-Qamis Wasikhun. Al-Labanu Baridun. Al-Masjid Maftuhun. Al-Hajar Kabirun. Al-Labanu Baridun. Wal-Ma'u Harun. Al-Muhandis. It's new word. Muhandis. Kulliyatul Hindisa. Yani, it means engineering college. And muhandis, engineer. Wal mudarris waqifun, and the teacher is standing. Al qamaru ba'id, the moon is far away. Al mindil nadif, the tissue is very clean. After this, there is a fill in the blanks. There are options. You have to fill up these options. in suitable places. Okay, number one, al hajar, the stone is what? The stone is beautiful, the stone is broken, the stone, what would be come here? Okay, it's you know that al hajar thaqil, the stone is heavy. Al-bab, the door what? The door is open, the door is closed like this. So al-bab maftuh or al-bab mughlaq, both can come here. Al-qamar, the moon is far away, the moon is beautiful, whatever you wanted to write. Look at the option and just fill up, okay? Al-waraq, it means paper. Al-mindil, handkerchief. Al-laban, the milk. The same way here, but here is a subject is in the blanks and predicate is already written. You have to fill up the subject. Like Nazif, which thing would be come here? Nazif, like a thawb Nazif, the cloth is clean. Al-mindil Nazif, like this. Maksur, what is broken? Maybe the pen is broken. Maybe the chair is broken. Al-kursiyu maksoor. Barid, al-asir barid, the juice. Al-ma barid, okay. Qareeb, al-masjid, al-bayt, whatever. Ba'id, waqif, jalis, kabir, qadim, jadid, okay. After this, al-kalimatul jadida, new words. So it's qamar, moon, jadid, new, qadim, old, wasikh, dirty, nazif, clean. Hard, hot, barid, cold, saghir, small, kabir, big, maftu, opened, maksur, broken, saqil, heavy, khafif, light, jameel, beautiful, waqif, standing, jalis, sitting. Okay? And then here is same thing, najmun and an-najmu. Najmun, any star, a star. An-najmu, the star. Rajulun, any man, a man. Ar-rajul, the man, which is in your mind. Okay, you wanted to talk about him. You wanted to give the information about him. Ar-rajulu mudarrisun. The man is a teacher. Ar-rajulu kabirun. The man is a big. Ar-rajulu saminun. The man is a heavy. You know, dubba. Deek, rooster. Ad-deek, the rooster. Talib, student. At-talib, the student. Okay. So here is an-najmu ba'id, al-rajul waqif, al-sukkar, sukkar means sugar, al-talib mariz, al-deek, rooster, daftar means notebook, al-tajir means merchant, the merchant is rich, ghani. Ya ayyuhan nas, Allahul ghani wa antum al-fuqara, al-dukkan maftuh, al-walad faqir, the boy is poor, al-tuffah laziz, tuffah, apple. At-tabib tawil wal mudarris qasir. Okay, after this another exercise, same way, al-babu and without alif lam babun, at-tajiru and without alif lam tajirun, same way. After imla al-faragh fima yali bi wad'i kalimatin munasiba, there is a, you know, subjects are hidden, only predicates are written. You have to bring the subject. Ghaniyun, who is rich, like a tajir, maybe. Hulwun, what is sweet, maybe sugar. Al-sukkar hulwun or al-tuffah hulwun. Mariz, maybe al-walad, maybe al-talib, maybe whatever you wanted to write. Laziz, tuffah, inab, kathir, yani hinak aqsamun wa anwa'un min al-fawakih. Okay, wa min al-ashiyah. Tawil, tall, qasir, short. And there is a match, you have to match, okay? A talib what? You have to match. A talib laziz, a talib maksur, saqil, maftu, mariz, har. Okay? So a talib mariz. A dukkan maftu. A tuffa laziz. Al ma har. Al hajar saqil. Al qalam maksur. Like this, okay? And after that, al-kalimatul jadida, there is a hulwun, sweet, okay? And also, Arab use hulwun like we use okay, So they will say halwa, halwa. Okay, theek hai, theek hai. Okay, ye aise bhi use karte hain kisi baat ko, acha halwa. Aur halwa na asal meaning mein aata hai sweet ke, meethe ke. Mareed, dukkan, ghani, tawil, faqir, qasir, tuffa. Okay, after this حروف القمرية and حروف الشمسية inshallah we will learn about this tomorrow. We will try it. شكرا جزاك الله. السلام عليكم.